Welcome back. This is episode number 32, and unfortunately I do feel like I'm starting to get a cold, which really sucks, so hopefully my voice will be okay, and I can keep doing this Let's Play this weekend, because I've been looking forward all week to having some time to actually play this game, and since I'm doing a Let's Play, I can't really play it without being able to talk. So, I may be talking a little bit less to save my voice, or I may sound different, but...
I'm sure he'll be in the nicer part of the castle. There is one.
This is Wraiths. Alright. At least they're susceptible to fire damage. My own barrier up. Looks like Cassandra get through. Oh, a rift. Can't attack that. But I can weaken it. A bit. Disrupt rift. Come on, use it. There we go. Alright, let's close the rift. So rifts are still a thing. And it seems like the Elder One is leading an army of demons, which makes me think he's probably trying to purposefully tear down the Veil and combine this world and the next. Interesting to ponder what the worst case scenario in that case is. Like, if there is no Veil, demons just move freely between the two worlds? Are there other strange repercussions? Like the rifts are... Oh, it's right at the channel. The rifts are bad enough, but having no veil at all... Interesting to ponder.
The Magister needs more power for his rituals.
No!
Come forth and serve the elf.
They just killed themselves? Feels like they did. What is that?
Alexius can't have wanted.
Oh, his shocky thing. If only we could show him what his master's done to the world. A new schematic, only a tier one, but. Like I said, you're meant to do this. Whoops. You're meant to do this between levels. I guess I should be using these potions as I go, just because you keep finding stashes of them. But yeah, this is meant to be between levels 4 and 7, so we did wait a little long before doing this quest. So maybe I'll just stick to the main quest for a while and see how that goes until we get to a point where we're caught up in levels. It is kind of like an MMO in that sense. What level are we at now? We're getting there. That's how we came in. Okay. Lots of levels, but they aren't very expansive.
The breach hits.
Whoa.
Everywhere.
The Elder One and his Venatori. They are the ones who opened the breach.
Kind of figured that out, but good to have it confirmed. And another rift. Much better barrier that time. Can't disrupt it right now. I think you can only disrupt it while their enemy's actually out. There we go. So yeah, like our world is starting to look more and more like the Fade. I wonder if the Red Lyrium has something to do... I mean, it has to be related somehow. See, I'm really curious. Is our world then just a realm of the Fade? Like, there was a theory that I think is probably not true, that the world of the Elder Scrolls is just one of the domains of Oblivion. But I wonder if in Dragon Age, Thedas is just one of the realms of the Fade. Maybe the Maker is just the most powerful demon, or actually a spirit, and this is his realm. That'd be kind of a cool resolution to the two mythologies, I guess. Maybe he created this world and made it specifically different from the rest of the Fade to give it rules and order. And that's why it doesn't look like the rest, but now that the Elder One is breaking through the laws of physics that maybe the Maker put up are being broken down. More rifts. And yeah, everything is just like floating up now and demons are everywhere. More and more like the rest of the Fade with each passing day. That's my theory for now, at least. We'll see what comes of it. Even though it's not surprising that they were the ones who made the rift, I still want to know why and what was supposed to happen. And what went wrong with it? Was it just a ritual that didn't go as planned, as magic is prone to do, or did someone or something interfere? Andraste, maybe? And is that the reason that I was somebody else supposed to get this mark, or... I really don't know. I think we're almost to the throne room. Oh, we're above it now. I guess we have to go back down. Oh, inventory's full. That's kind of cool. A cooldown amulet. Alright, let's... And that's our new increased inventory as well. I forgot that we were getting close to full after the end of our episode before last, because I hadn't played in a while. Alright, so let's scroll down to valuables. Hopefully none of these are too valuable. Thing is, in this game you can always farm more money, so it sucks selling these, but they're probably not worth that much anyway. So what we don't need are more of those potion... or the health potion restocking things. What we need is a merchant. Alexius's journal. The final entry. Nothing works. I've tried countless times to go back before the Conclave explosion, before Felix's caravan was attacked by Darkspawn, before the Venatori first arrived in Minrathus, without success. Interesting. So the Conclave explosion was the most recent event, which he's trying to fix. Felix's caravan was attacked by Darkspawn, so it sounds like it's probably the Darkspawn taint that's infecting him. Before the Venatori first arrived in Minrathus, so the cult started elsewhere and then infiltrated to Venture's capital, and eventually he joined them. The breach is the wellspring that makes this magic possible, and travel outside of its timeline is impossible. Ah, okay. That's kind of interesting. So you can't go before the breach occurred, which is at the Conclave explosion. The Elder One's demand that I change the events of the Conclave can never be fulfilled. He may kill me for failing him, but I must protect Felix from his wrath. I do like they added his son there. It gives him some dimension to his character. Let's see what loot is in his bedroom. A longbow. Why he has a longbow, who knows. But maybe he likes practicing archery for fun.
No!
What? What happened? Oh, was it Connor? I'm so confused. What am I seeing? I guess those bastards? I don't...
How can those bastards want a world like this?
They want it to be just like the world of old Tevinter. Comforting, isn't it? He resisted that demon to the last.
Is there a dead body somewhere I'm missing? Who just screamed no? I am so confused. Spellbinder's journal. Every failed time spell, the Magister grows a bit more paranoid. Perhaps It's not paranoia, since the Elder One really will kill him for his failures. The distraction hardly matters. After the 10th failure, he began locking himself in the Great Hall. After the 20th, he had foot soldiers excavate a shard doorway from parts unknown and install it in the castle. Now his most trusted assistants can only see him if we all go at once together, which we must do twice a day to bring him his meals, as he never leaves the room at all. Paranoid indeed. Maybe it was outside, whatever? I feel like there's supposed to be a body of Connor around here or something. Or did we kill a demon that was Connor's? I don't know. Oh! This, maybe? The blood trail? Maybe that's what they're talking about? I really don't know. Anything in here? Not really. Are we going backwards? I think we are. Okay. That's Connor's room, right? Or whatever room we thought was Connor's. Alright, so we need to go through the story over here.
What became of Felix? Do you know?
Yes, I know.
And you're not going to tell me?
You'll find out soon enough.
He became a ghoul, I'm guessing? He was infected by the Darkspawn. Almost there. Is that Veil Fire or regular fire? Hard to tell. Some more tier 1 schematics. Here we go. I see an enemy beyond the wall there. Lots of enemies. You guys ready? Yeah, my barrier empowered my fire spells there. Did more than 2,000 damage. And reduced the cooldown. Fade Rift. Oh, I'm down. Did not notice my health at all. I wish the health bars were down here in the... Alright. Where's the Elvara? There she is. Can I knock it if I have aggro? Alright, well, you keep aggro then. Varric, you'll revive the Elvara. Not too worried still, because these guys really aren't that tough. Are you rezzing or not? No, you just keep standing up again. There we go. Plus we have Liliana fighting with us too, even though she's not actually in the party. Yeah.
This is the way to the main hall. Alexius will likely be there.
What in Andraste's name is that? Hold on to it. I want to look at it later.
Hyderium shards. We've only found one. Are there more in this room, or do we miss all the others? Or are there more levels to come? Supply cache. I'm going to use one of these potions then. Restock. Are we going up here? Or no, I guess. I don't know whether we should go up first and then try to get the amulet back, or if the amulet is up here, if the amulet is elsewhere. Like, they could really make this quest long and make the amulet be taken to a different city. We could explore a different area of the world in the future. Or he might still have it on him or somewhere in the castle.
How much damage did Alexius' spell do?
Rifts tore apart all of southern Thedas, starting here. But whether that's his doing or the breach, who can say?
Here, let's make, you know what?
Are we still in the hinterlands, technically? No. Okay, so these are the same quest. Ooh, Masterwork Waveblade, okay. Sounds interesting. So it's possible this area up here only exists for the bonus quest. See, it doesn't say though, I guess these are the shards? Let's head back down. I don't want to move forward with the quest until we find the shards for Dorian. One of them's way over there, or is that the throne room? Hard to tell. You said it, Varric. Is that guy a priest? Spellbinder.
Venatory severance package stinks.
There's a shard. Let's see if we can use any of their loot. Can't use any of those. Yeah. Not that good anyway. Alright, not sure what the point of that really was. There's nothing up here. I guess they were repairing the windows or something. There's something over here, though. Oh, it's the ladder. Never mind. It's over there. There's one. Did we already loot this thing? Yeah. That's why I hate having the my inventory full. I can never tell what I looted and what I didn't. That could be the throne room, though, most likely. It's a pretty important looking door. Alright. Testing? Alright. I think we're okay. My headset just turned itself off, but I turned it back on again, and I see that it's picking up the audio, so I think we're okay. Door's closed, so I guess we haven't been through there yet. What's up here? More supply caches, jeez. They really make this level easy for you, don't they? Wonder if those might not be there on Nightmare Mode. See, now we pass by. This place is confusing. There's nothing here. It's not making a purple circle either. It's possible you actually need these red shards to get to the throne room anyway. Alright, let's see what's inside here.
Let's take out that enchanter quickly.
We're not out of combat. Well. This one? Spellbinder? I missed.
Block them from coming up the stairs.
I would if I hadn't wasted my fire mine already.
I could really go for some light reading.
This be the library. There we go. Number three. Can't take that. I really wish I had sold everything before I came into this. I hate leaving all this loot behind. Especially because we'll never be back here in the future to grab it all again. Alright. See, we can go ahead over here, but it looks like... I'm really confused why this marker... Are they on a different level, maybe? Oh, they're down. I don't know. I don't want to trigger the next section by accident without getting these lyrium shards, if that's even possible. But I feel like that door we saw is probably it.
Somebody had very questionable taste.
More enemies. Most of the shards seem to drop from the enemies, so...
They haven't seen us. We could take them by surprise.
I wonder if maybe these...
They have mercy on your souls. No one else.
Didn't... Wasn't that like Liliana's line? Or was the... I think it was the... May the Maker have mercy on your souls, because I won't. Something like that. It's one of her battle cries from Origins. Maybe these red shards are what the advisors need to get into his room, because it said they only let all of his trusted advisors in there at once. So maybe we're basically killing his five trusted advisors to get the red lyrium shards, which will allow us to gain access to his room. That would make sense. We still okay. See, there's so these aren't the shards. These must just be. I don't know. We already got this guy. Yeah. Let's head to the next room over then and see if that's. Well, let's see what's up here first. Possibly nothing, but worth a shot. I wonder if maybe the idea is we're supposed to climb up here and then cast fire down on them from above. That could be what they mean by surprise attack. And that could explain why these platforms are here. Well, it took me a bit, but I figured it out eventually. See, we can't go over... It looks like there's a door there, but there's not. Or am I just missing it? Oh, there is a door. Huh. I'm just blind, okay. Yet another supply cache. More stuff I can't take. I guess you can only go this way if you have... Oh, wait a minute, we do have a rogue. Good job, Eric. Bad guys around here somewhere, and probably the fifth shard. And that goes back the way we came. So what's the point of having that door that you can unlock if you just go in this way instead? Maybe it's just supposed to be hard to find that way? I don't know. Can't we just break off five pieces of one of these things and do it that way? Maybe if you have a rogue, all these doors, you can go in the back way and surprise them? Is that the idea? Maybe it's in case you come this way first and then go to the other room, that would have been a surprise? I don't know. I'm gonna try not to overthink this. What is that? Oh. I see. It's a wall you can bash down for a surprise attack. Do I want that? Level 4, not really. Might sell for a bit, but... Cassandra, if you would do the honors for me, please. Oh, he's got a book there. another wall there. I say, how do you get into this room besides bashing the walls down, but there actually is a door? Hey, there's the fifth shard.
Okay. Back to the main hall. I think I know how we'll open that door.
Introduction of blight to prisoners yields no discernible pattern. Disease progresses erratically. Some die within hours, others show no symptoms. Six subjects die. Transfusions of blood from resistant prisoners slow the rate of corruption only slightly. Alright. This goes against donor flesh faster than regular flesh. Prisoner Liliana has been the most useful source of resistant blood and skin to date. Huh. Why is she... That explains her face, but why is she resistant to it? Just from fighting them so much with the warden? Maybe being around the warden... gives her some... resistance? Not sure. You say I stink like them? It's not really a good war cry. I stink like them. Alright, it's hard when they don't show the walls on the map. I can't really tell what's what. I think we've looted most of these areas though. Why there are three markers, I'm not really sure. I guess the throne room is there, so you have to go through. Or maybe these are three different doors to the throne room? I don't know. This level is confusing me. But that's okay. We're getting to the end of it soon, I think. See? Because there's that marker. I guess because we're on a different level. Okay, these three things light up to say you need to go down to the next level. That's what it is. I getcha. Once again, my headset turned off. I don't know why it is doing that. It does that sometimes, always has, but it's really annoying. So if you hear me go silent mid-conversation for a couple seconds, that's why. Luckily, I notice when it goes off because I stop hearing the in-game music, so I will be back momentarily whenever that happens. Might just have to buy a new headset at some point. Well, I think this is a pretty nice one, so... not sure I want to replace it. Alright, let's do a quick save. And then head inside. There are the five shards. So that's his magical door. Oh, that must be the door they talked about. I getcha, in that one journal entry. Like the ones that are in Silicon. Is that Felix? I know why he's alone, because, he's paranoid.
It's over, Alexius.
So it is. I knew you would appear again. Not that it would be now, but I knew I hadn't destroyed you. My final failure.
Was it worth it? Everything you did to the world, to yourself.
It doesn't matter now. All we can do is wait for the end.
So I wish he could give you, like, I don't know, tell us something that only he would know, so when we go back to the past and talk to previous Alexius, we can convince him that his future self agreed with us and didn't want him to go through with all of this.
What do you mean? What's ending?
The world, apparently.
The irony that you should appear now, of all the possibilities. All that I fought for, all that I betrayed, and what have I wrought? Ruin and death. That is nothing else. The Elder One comes for me, for you, for us all. Felix.
That's Felix. Maker's breath, Alexius. What have you done?
He would have died, Dorian. I saved him. Please, don't hurt my son. I'll do anything you ask.
Hand over the amulet, and we let him go.
Let him go, and I swear you'll get what you want.
I won the world back.
No.
So help us back to the past. No! Help us undo it, Alexius. Guess we have to fight him now. Can dispel him, but they're gonna, they're gonna get the shield down first. Oh, he slowed us. Time magic, interesting. I like that though. Did he make a rift? Yep, he did. Sorry, Miss Cassandra. The Wraith is trying to line of sight me. Alright, let's close the rift. Oop. I can click on it. There we go. Let's get my shield up for some extra power. Didn't do that much damage. On top of this fire mine here. There we go. Got another one. Okay. Another good fire spell buffed by that barrier. I think I'm gonna give all my mages barrier just for that bonus alone. Oh, I have to close it. That's right. Where is it? Would you stop making rifts, Alexius? That's how you got into this mess. Combo on him. Do just a bat. Give a barrier up. Don't have enough mana for it. There we go. Hey, we got some good items. Staff of Stasis.
He wanted to die, didn't he? All those lies he told himself, the justifications. He lost Felix long ago. Didn't even notice.
Yeah, we can still stop all this.
This Alexius was too far gone, but the Alexius in our time might still be reasoned with.
I suppose that's true. This is the same amulet he used before. I think it's the same one we made in Minrathus. That's a relief. Give me an hour to work out the spell he used, and I should be able to reopen the rift.
An hour? That's impossible! You must go now!
What's happening, Liliana? What was Alexius talking about? What is this end?
The Eldor.
You have to hurry. This
he's here?
Is bad.
This is like KOTOR. When Malak was coming in, you had to escape before he arrived. An enemy too powerful to defeat.
Once they break through, it's all you, Nightingale.
I think she'd approach the situation logically that it's not letting them die, because if we're going to go back to the past anyway, this future will never happen. This is sad.
We'll make this count.
The only way we live is if this day never comes.
Just like X-Men Days of Future Past.
Cast your spell. You have as much time as I have arrows.
Hopefully you have a lot of arrows. Fight well, my friends. You're fighting for your own lives as well, if we can get back to the past.
Though darkness closes, I am shielded by flame. Andraste, guide me. Maker, take me to your side.
You move! And we all die!
She wasn't out of arrows yet. There we go.
You're
You'll have to do better than that.
At least he knows when he's been beaten.
Put aside all claim to Redcliff and we let you live.
You won. There is no point extending this charade, Felix.
It's going to be all right, Father.
You'll die.
Everyone dies.
Well, I'm glad that's over with. Or not.
Are those to Venture?
Grand Enchanter, we'd like to discuss your abuse of our hospitality.
Your Majesties, when we offered the Mage's Sanctuary, we did not give them the right to drive our people from their homes. King Alistair, Queen Honora.
So I thought it was. Sounds like them. They look different.
Never intended.
In light of your actions, good intentions are no longer enough.
You and your followers have worn out your welcome. Leave Ferelden, or we'll be forced to make you leave.
But we have hundreds who need protection. Where will we go?
Yeah, we still need mages. They look so different. I mean, I guess they're older too, but they don't look older. They just look different. I think Bioware could have spent a little more time trying to get the character models to look more similar to the ones from previous games.
I should point out that we did come here for mages to close the breach.
And what are the terms of this arrangement?
Hopefully better than what Alexius gave you. The Inquisition is better than that, yes?
I know you are a mage, but consider how these rebels have acted. They must be conscripted, not coddled.
I've known a lot of mages. They can be loyal friends if you let them. Friends who make bad decisions, but still loyal.
It seems we have little choice but to accept whatever you offer.
Well, this is an important choice because it has the servants, or what is it? They conscript the rebel mages into the service of the Inquisition, or offer the rebel mages a full alliance. Yeah, as a mage herself, she would definitely go with this choice.
We would be honored to have you fight as allies at the Inquisition's side.
We'll discuss this later.
I'll pray that the rest of the Inquisition honors your promise, then.
The breach threatens all of Thedas. We cannot afford to be divided now. We can't fight it without you. Any chance of success requires your full support.
It's a generous offer. I doubt you're going to get a better one from us.
So those are Freldon's Royal Guard, I guess.
We accept. Him. It would be madness not to. I will gather my people and ready them for the journey to Haven. The breach will be closed. You will not regret giving us this chance.
Hope not. You think Alistair and Nora would have been wearing like some kind of armor as well, even though they're surrounded by guards. Like, they're still in a very dangerous part of Freldon. You never know what could happen. A poem, I guess. I'm not going to bother reading that, because it'll load before... Oh, it's a song! Oh, nice.
It's not a matter for debate. There will be abominations among the mages, and we must be prepared.
If we rescind the offer of an alliance, it makes the Inquisition appear incompetent at best, tyrannical at worst.
What were you thinking, turning mages loose with no oversight? The veil is torn open.
I lied to them. I mean, we do have former Templars here. I'm sure we have plenty of soldiers who can keep an eye on the mages within our army. Just as what happens when mages are used in any standing army. Where's my cursor? There it is.
We're not monsters. We can control ourselves without any outside help.
This is not an issue of self-control. Even the strongest mages can be overcome by demons in conditions like these. You were there, Seeker. Why didn't you intervene?
While I may not completely agree with the decision,
I support it. The sole point of the Herald's mission was to gain the mage's aid, and that was accomplished.
The voice of pragmatism speaks. And here I was, just starting to enjoy the circular arguments.
Closing the breach is all that matters.
Did Colin always have that stubble, or did that just start, like, I kind of hope that he, like, grows a beard as the game goes on. That'd be a cool little addition, but I feel like it was always there, and I just never noticed it before. Alright. Are we actually going to close the breach now?
The longer the breach is open, the more damage it does. We should head there as soon as possible.
Agreed.
We should look into the things you saw in this dark future. The assassination of Empress Selene. A demon army.
Sounds like something a Tevinter cult might do. Orle falls, the Imperium rises. Chaos for everyone.
One battle at a time. It's going to take time to organize our troops and the mage recruits. Let's take this to the war room. Join us. None of this means anything without your mark, after all.
See, if future Liliana had been more helpful, then maybe past Liliana would have the answer she wants. But no, she couldn't tell us anything that was going on. It had to be a surprise.
Of course. Meet us there when you're ready.
I'll skip the war council, but I would like to see this breach up close, if you don't mind.
Then you're staying?
Oh, didn't I mention? The South is so charming and rustic. I adore it to little pieces.
Hopefully not literally. And I guess this is your choice to see whether or not he stays in your party. So this is the only one that's... he will not... See, I'm not really surprised he would want to stay. I think as a fellow mage, I'd actually be happy to have him here. I think she's perhaps a little more trusting of her fellow mages than she should be.
There's no one I'd rather be stranded in time with, future or present.
That's excellent a little much, choice. But okay.
But let's not get stranded again anytime soon, yes?
I'll begin preparations to march on the summit. Make a willing, the mages will be enough to grant us victory.
In all honesty, Templars probably would have been the better choice just because Templars are made to fight demons and... Well, only one power for the next quest, I guess. But, demons in their kind. But I'd rather side with the mages because mages are awesome. Alright, so let's look at our quest log real quick. Inquisitor's Path. So, those weren't two branches of the main quest. You have to complete both of them before moving on. They were an either-or thing. So the next time is just to march on the breach and close it, which is... See, I would have thought that would have been, if not the end of the game, at least pretty darn close to it, but we're, you know, it's only a level, oh, I don't know what level it is, maybe level 8 quest, because like, it was level 4 to 7 last time. So we'll go to the war room and we'll see what level quest it is. But first, I have some merchandise to sell, and I'm going to do that between episodes, and I will meet you guys back here when I'm done.